I never thought I'd say this, but I reckon Lisa Fernandez may just have met her match this morning. Let's check out where she is. She's about to go head-to-head with one of Perth's toughest ladies.
Oh, let me tell you about Erin McGowan, all right? I want her on everyone's radar this morning. Erin McGowan is a Perth girl. She's a former world WBO champion, OK? And what's happening on Friday, Tim, is that she's taking on some chick called Arlene, all right, in a world title fight right here in Perth. So I'm going to have a chat with Erin. Look, I'll be honest with you. I love boxing because I, you know, just do it down at the gym for some fitness myself. Didn't know about Erin, but she's a Perth girl that we can all be really proud of because she's achieved so much in the female boxing world, and she is an absolute champion. World title, check her out. So I bought my pink Everlast gloves.
Pink gloves. It might be your only tactic. That could be you, that boxing bag behind you. That could be you soon.
No, wait. What she goes, I said, oh, look, don't go too hard, you know, because you've got a world title fight on Friday. She goes, oh, don't worry, I'm just chatting. And the camel almost fell over.
Thank you, Lisa. See you soon. Maybe for
all
the last
see you
time.
Soon.
Fernandez spends a lot of time on her phone. You've sent about 4 million tweets in your time, haven't you, Lise? But it's a different kind of physical danger that you're about to face this morning.
Yeah, actually, I tweeted last night about this and said, if I was going to take on Erin, like, where would you put your money?
I do like an underdog, Lise, but, you know, I don't like to lose as well. So I'm going to take a safe bet here. And I know you are,
you,
Lisa,
Erin.
The flying fist. Thank Fernandez, you. But I'm going to go with the favourite this time.
OK, now listen, Erin McGowan is someone who I want everyone to know in Perth because she's a world title champion and she's a Perth girl. Morning, Erin.
Good morning.
You have a world title fight this Friday against Arlene Blencowe, blah, 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 whatever. We'll get onto her later. Tell us how you got into boxing. I'm so intrigued by this story.
Oh, you know, I played a lot of competitive sport when I was younger. I was probably a little bit too competitive.
Yeah.
I had my son quite young,
yes.
Lost my health and fitness for a bit there, and was determined to get fit and healthy again. And boxing was probably one of the hardest things I'd had to do at that point. And, you know, at the end of the day, you've only got yourself in there. I wasn't much of a team player.
Now, yeah, but hang on a minute. I've boxed, right? I do a bit of box fit. When did you know that you were actually really good at it? When they went, oh, hang on, this chick's got it.
Initially, I didn't want to get punched in the head when I very first started.
Yeah.
And the trainers down there wanted me to fight. And I was like, I don't want to get punched in the head.
Yeah.
And I had a sparring session with a couple of the younger boys that beat up on me a little bit.
Yeah.
And I was like, hey, I'll be back tomorrow to spar you boys again. And I just, my competitive streak override. And then I had my first fight and I beat the state champ and it sort of all just went from there.
Now, Erin McGowan, remember her name. Erin's actually fought overseas in one of the biggest boxing nations in the world, haven't you?
Yeah, I fought for the WBC in South America, actually, which is a pretty scary country to go and fight when you've got the whole world against you. And absolutely won that fight and didn't get the decision, which caused a lot of controversy around the world, and the WBC ordered it a rematch and things like that. So, and then I fought in Belgium for the IBF, another huge world title.
Wow, but, look at you, and you're a Perth girl, I love it. Now, you've got a 16-year-old son.
Yes.
Well, he's 16 now.
Yep.
So, like, you actually could bash him up, couldn't you?
If I had to.
Now, okay, so just do a scenario with me. You're in the house and you go, hey, tidy your room. And what if he smart-mouths you? What, like, has he ever done that?
Yeah, he's a 16-year-old boy, so he definitely tries his luck. But I think he knows when he pushes it to the limit, he gets the look and he's like, OK, Mum.
OK.
And he'll back down and go do what he's told.
Show us the look. Tim wants to see the look. What's the look? Yeah, she did the look.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the look, yeah.
Yeah, OK.
You don't want to mess with that.
Feeling it.
He feels it. OK, Erin, listen. I want you to teach me just a couple of boxing moves next in the 8:30.
Yeah, sure.
And while we do that, boxing moves, I'm going to learn from a world champion. No, I'm not saying that I want to punch anyone's head in at Channel 9, but there are a couple of people that could do with a punch in the face, all right? So
I'll show you a good move then.
All right, you show me a good move. We'll be back at 8:30 and we'll talk more about the world title fight, which is happening on Friday night. World title she's going for, and we want to get everyone behind her. Erin McGowan, Perth girl, world title. I'll be back at 8:30, Tim, with moves you wouldn't believe.
And
we'll see you then.
Is the cat fight on? Can we start calling it? Is the cat fight happening?
Tim wants to go, is the cat fight happening? Like that?
Cat fight?
Yeah, that's
Tim.
It with Tim. We'll just come back and get Tim. Yeah, Tim, it's happening. All right, we've got to go. I'll be back with the weather.
Tim, you're going to get a cat fight.
Yeah, I know. I've got to be careful. Thank you. Back to Lisa, the Flying Fist Ferandez now for all the weather details.
I think she heard you say flying fist, so she's a bit worried. So she's actually practicing.
She's giving a little bit of practice in.
Yeah, have a look. Yeah. Currently in this city, it's 19.3. 33 degrees we should be getting by Tuesday. So
that's if you're still alive,
I'm here
then, Lisa.
With the world champion boxing behind me. Catch you at 8:30 with some actual moves, and we'll see if we can go mano a mano. Was that a basketball term? No, that's all right. I can use that. One-on-one?
Yeah, that'll do. Thank you, Lisa. We'll see you then. Don't forget our special report. Let's check in with our very own Rocky, the Flying Fist Ferandez. Lise, you're all gloved up, ready to go. Can I ask, have you sorted out some temporary care for your lovely daughter and your dog, just in case the unthinkable happens here?
Certainly have. They're coming to your place. Okay, so here's the thing. Erin McGowan, right? She's behind me in the ring. She's pretty amazing. She's a Perth girl. She's vying for her world title fight. It's happening this Friday against Arlene the Anger Blencowe. Is it the Anger? Anger Fist. What a stupid name. Sorry, Arlene. All right. Okay, what am I doing? I'm trash talking.
She hides
like
you as her personal trash talker, has she?
I am so for it. Anyway, I've learned a move, okay? I have been taught a couple of boxing moves. We're going to find out about this world title fight, what it means, find out about Erin McGowan, a little bit more. Perth girl who's done good. Look at her. She's amazing. I'm so impressed, Tim. I'm sold. I'm absolutely sold. And it's a big fight, and we want to get behind her, Perth.
Yep.
So more to come on this from me shortly in about 5 minutes. And
no
Arlene,
way in the
if
world
you're watching,
I'd be messing with her.
You know, sorry about that.
Thank you, Lisa. We'll see you soon. Go back to Lisa Ferandez now, and the time is almost nigh. Lisa, the gloves are on.
Yep, the gloves are
ready?
On, Tim. We're in the ring. Okay, well, let me just tell you a little bit about Erin McGowan, firstly. She's a Perth girl, done really good in the boxing world. Her nickname, I just found out, is Erin the Blueprint McGowan.
Yeah, what's that about? Can you answer?
You explain to Tim.
I was given that nickname through the media, mainly from a ring announcer. He feels that I was the blueprint of female boxing, and I put female boxers in Australia on the world map, so that name kind of just stuck with me.
And look at
her,
she's so modest. She doesn't want to say it, but you know, like, she really has, and I love the fact that Erin's from Perth. So here we go, Tim. Just wait. Erin's showing me a couple of moves. So Erin,
of the girls some boxing fitness, I teach them number one thing is their hands up so their jaw's nice and safe. That's where you get knocked out.
Yep.
So we want to have a nice tight defense. You're going to throw a left, right at me.
Left,
right, slip, and come back with a power hand.
Okay.
So you throw left, right, slip.
I'm
right,
ready. I'm ready.
Really come back with that right hand. Left, right, slip.
Yeah, good girl.
Oh, nice. Hands up, elbows in to protect your wrist.
Oh, almost got her. What the hell?
Left, right, slip. Right, good girl. Hands up. That's it. Oh,
okay,
in.
So what I'm doing right now is
look
I'm pretending
at those dancing feet.
Yeah, and feet. Nice.
I'm pretending that you're Tim, okay?
Right,
ready?
Then,
you're Tim now. What would you say?
Left, right, slip.
Yeah.
What'd you say?
Okay.
Okay. Tim.
Okay.
Good girl. Nice. Nice tight fist so we don't hurt your hand. Left, right, slip. Right.
Good girl. Now, Erin, tell me. Let's get serious now. Let's talk about this fight. Tell me about this chick.
Arlene Blencowe, look, it's a big world title fight.
Yep.
I'm expecting 10 tough rounds.
Yep.
She's naturally a bigger, stronger girl at her weight, but she's coming down to meet me halfway.
Yep.
So she's coming down the weight. She's got to cut the weight, and I've got to put on a little bit of weight.
Yep.
So I'm stepping up from super featherweight to lightweight, and she's coming down from light welter. So we're meeting halfway.
Yep.
You know, the plan for me is to just box smart, do what I do. Yeah. I've got 13 years of international fight experience, which I need to take into the ring with me on Friday night.
Yep. Do you guys trash talk?
I don't like to trash talk. A lot of fighters do. But no, that's just me. I don't mind other people
Good
doing
thing
it.
You're
that's
there,
completely
then,
fine. I just generally I like to just focus on what I've got to do in there.
Yes.
And if I start focusing on trash talking her, that's taking my mind away from the job that I've got to complete.
Yeah. Well, I'm kind of glad that you said that, because I can only think of one word that rhymes with Blencowe, and it's not a really nice one. So I guess we don't really want to go there. Blencowe, you are no, we won't do it. Okay. So Italian Club, we're going to let you know on the screen how you can get tickets to your bout if you want to see this. It is a world title fight happening. And just like that was really you get really puffed out. All right, now, so just say we were in a fight.
Yeah.
What's your move? What's your knockout move? Like, how would you do it?
Oh, Lise, if we were going to, I wouldn't want to hurt your pretty little face. Okay, so I'd probably get your hands up. I'd trick you with the
head. There's the trash talking.
In the body.
Okay, and then how would I defend myself against that?
Oh, if you were quick enough, you'd block and then drop down and block to the body.
Okay, so you'd go do it again.
So your hands up nice and high. Yeah. That's it, you're going to block and then drop your elbows to block. Yeah, so
how would I get you?
Maybe when I go to the body and throw a left hook at my head, maybe.
Oh, yeah. Okay, we're going to practice some of these moves.
So you're always looking for openings. You're tricking your opponent.
Yeah.
You want them to open up so you can attack on that opening.
Tim is laughing in the studio. What he doesn't know is that I'm bringing these boxing gloves back for that move. Big guy.
For that big right hand.
Yeah. I'm still trying to work out what rhymes with Blencowe.
And guys, you can get tickets online with CDL Promotions or CDL Boxing.
Yeah. Okay, what rhymes with Blencowe starts with an H. Anyway, I'm going to be back with the weather shortly. Erin McGowan, get behind it. She's a world champ from Perth. Back
get
to
on
you,
Lise. Thanks,
guys.
We'll see you shortly. There could be a bit more rain on the way. We'll have all the details straight after the break. See you soon. Let's go back to Lisa Ferandez for all the weather details. Lisa, you've survived. Congratulations.
Thanks very much. I do know how to box a little bit. No, actually, I don't. She was very kind, Erin McGowan.
You talk a good game.
World champion. I do. I'm a good trash talker. I think she's taking me into the ring just for that. 20.9 degrees we are in the city right now. So, from me here, I just want to say thanks for having us this morning. Great to meet Erin. Even if you're not into boxing, I tell you right now, what she's achieved is pretty phenomenal for a Perth girl. We should all be really proud of her. Erin McGowan, she is taking on Arlene Blencowe this Friday night at the Italian Club.
So I've just been informed what rhymes with Blencowe now. Good stuff.
It took you a while.
Well,
and took
I was thinking of something that rhymed both
while.
Syllables and, you know, I was racking my brain. I couldn't... Anyway.
I'll see you back at the station.
Anyway,
with the gloves
too much
on.
Away. Too much work. Well, congratulations on surviving. Thanks, Lise. We'll see you tomorrow.